In this video, we'll discuss the basic overview of the ALT-8000. To begin, if not already opened, click on the gray launch bar to display the function keys. First function key is simulation. On the simulation page, you have two sections, control and UT parameters. UT parameters is all the parametrics being measured from the transmitter under test. The control provides all the information back to the receiver under test to control the altitude rate, and the received power level. At the bottom of the page is the run button and the indicator to determine the status, whether it's running or stopped. Any of the boxes outlined in blue are not editable by the user. Any of the boxes that are outlined in white are editable by the user unless they show a locked button. If you see the lock, it means that it's in a state right now that doesn't allow user intervention. The next function key is profile setup. The profile setup page allows the user to configure an altitude profile, whether it's a ramp from a single altitude to another altitude, or a multi-tiered simulation. This page allows the user to configure the profile by adding legs, editing legs, removing legs that already exist. You can create and manage the profiles here. You can store them and then recall them for future use. How to create and manage the profiles will be covered in a later video. The next function key is test setup. On the test setup page, you have four tabs: general, loss, storage, and display. From the general tab, you have UUT settings. UUT settings determines the type of readout that's being tested and whether it's manually selected or automatically detected. The RF settings can be manually controlled or auto-detected as well. The connection type, whether it's direct or coupled or connected to the feeder line, must be manually selected. Delay settings determine whether there's an AID cable installed on the aircraft and allows the user to select the length of the AID cable. The altitude offset fine-tunes our simulation to the aircraft's indicator to have a starting point for linearity checks. Delay calibration is covered in another video. Altitude indicator zero allows you to zero the indicator to match our simulated altitude for linearity test while the system is running. The loss tab allows you to enter the cable, coupler, or any external attenuation loss values so that they are accommodated when the test is running. Storage. This allows you to save and recall all settings in the test set. The display tab allows the user to configure the displayed parametrics. This will only need to be set up one time. Details of test setup will be covered in its own video. The next function key is maintenance. The diagnostics, calibration, and systems info subkeys are only used for maintenance of the unit. They're not used in normal operation and will not be covered in this video. The next function key is self-test. Self-test allows the user to determine if the unit is functioning properly. If you're having a continued failure and you suspect that the test set is faulty, you can run this test and be assured that the test set is operational or that there is an internal fault. The next and final function key is system. To access the system function key, click on the down arrow. You can see it's highlighted, indicating that there's additional function keys that the user cannot see. Under the system function key, You have three selections for subkeys: System Configuration, Options, System Update. Under System Configuration, you have multiple tabs: Status, Hardware, UI Options, Network, Date and Time. Status just gives you an indication of the status of your system. Hardware gives you the status of the hardware installed in your unit. UI Options gives you the ability to brighten your backlight. So when you're using the test set on a bright sunny day, you can brighten it so it's easier to see in direct sunlight. Network. This allows you to remote interface to the unit via Ethernet. This allows you to set it up via DHCP, static IP. Date and time just sets the internal date and time of the unit. To access the additional functions, press the gray launch bar, select System, Options. The Options tab will show you any options that are installed in the unit. Currently, there's no available options for this test set. The serial number is displayed down below and unique IDs that would be tied to any options. Select the gray launch bar, System, System Update. To update your software in your system, you would select Copy from USB to download the software from your USB device. Install the software to install it on your system. The current version of software is displayed along with the serial number of the unit and versions.